Africa. Hello, Cameroon, and welcome to another beautiful episode of Shine Africa. We are still in Buea, the Southwest Regional Capital, and of course, we are still at the Mountain Hotel. And I'd like to say a very big thank you to the management of this hotel for all the care they've given to us, to the crew, a crew of 10, and also to our guests. When I visited the Southwest region some months back, I met a choir, the Cameroon Afro Gospel Choir, and I fell in love with them. And I said, oh, I was going to let you enjoy what I enjoyed back then. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the Cameroon Afro Gospel Choir.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
So my love, I
da 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 da
Maloba,
shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
You're welcome back from that very, very beautiful break, ladies and gentlemen. That was a well-deserved introduction for this program, and you're still in the company of Shine Africa, and we are at the Mountain Hotel in Buea, Cameroon. Ladies and gentlemen, my guest is the director, the founder of the Cameroon Afro Gospel Choir, Mr. Focho Betrand. Put your hands together for him. Please, that way. Thank you. Thank you very much for coming on the show. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
It's my pleasure. You asked for us to do the orange juice. Orange juice, okay? Please come to my kitchen where we do the happy juice.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
Why did you choose oranges?
The citrus fruit, they really help with the voice.
Wow.
You know, choir, so the citrus fruit help for the voice.
You did not tell me that. I should have been having it all day long since I came here to Buea. I don't want to ask you if you have a juicer at home, but do you have it?
No, I don't. I don't have a juicer at home. Not yet.
Not yet, yeah. It's very important to have it because it's a smart way of doing natural juices. You just get into your kitchen. Are you married?
No, not yet.
Not yet.
Maybe when I'm married, I'm going to have a juicer. Oh.
Okay. Our juice is now ready. On Shine Africa, this gentleman before lady. So I serve you first.
Thank you.
It's my pleasure. What's your favorite color, please?
Color is blue. Royal blue.
Ah, God. Unfortunately, I do not have that here. So what other color do you want here?
Yellow, purple,
red?
Purple will go somewhere close to royalty.
Yeah, it's close. Your glass. My favorite color is lemon green. I don't have it, so let me take a yellow. Please, can you have a sip of your juice?
Of course.
These are oranges freshly gotten from the supermarket early this morning. That's the only market I know in Buea for now. Before we take leave of you, ladies and gentlemen, remember that a kitchen without a juicer is not alive. A kitchen without a juicer is not alive.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, from that orange break. And in the company, still in the company of the founder and the CEO of the Cameroon Afro Gospel Choir, Mr. Focho Betrand.
That's right.
Focho, it sounds like a name from the Northwest region.
Of course, from the Northwest region of Cameroon.
Yeah, from which village, please?
From Bengui.
From Bengui.
Yes.
Akiriye.
Mochicham.
Oh God, I still remember some of it anyway. And I like your vision for a young man like you too, because this is something that Cameroon doesn't do. A non-denominational choir or interdenominational. So it brings together all the denominations.
Christian denominations.
Christian denominations. Christian.
Christian. Strictly Christian.
Okay.
It's a gospel choir.
It's a gospel choir. That's beautiful. That's beautiful. So what was your motivation behind this choir?
Looking at the Cameroonian landscape when it comes to music, especially choral music, I realized several years back that Cameroon is nowhere found on the map of the world or even Africa when it comes to choral music.
Yeah.
So having been in the University of Buea choir for a decade plus, I was inspired throughout my stay in the choir to think about something, to dream or something.
You are eloquent. I'll let you host this show.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
So we're dreaming. I was not dreaming alone. There were others dreaming with me from that same choir. And so when it was time, I believe that it was also a divine hand in a dreaming process that led us to a brighter day when we decided in 2016 to come together and put together this beautiful jewel. I call it National Treasure.
Yeah, what did you read at the university, please?
I read linguistics at a bachelor's level, and now I'm doing a Master of Arts in Translation.
So you're still a student?
I'm still a student.
Yeah, but the choir is so big. It's a choir of 20 plus and...
We're 35 plus.
35 plus.
Yes, this is just a representation.
And you do auditions every year every 2 years?
Every year, as need arises.
Yeah, okay. Yes. Mm-hmm. But that can be too bad for a choir to do auditions every 12 months. So how do you manage that?
Now, with our situation here in Buea, you know, Buea is a town of students.
Yeah,
it's okay. Predominantly student-based. So you have students who constantly move out of Buea after their studies for greener pastures, out of the country or out of the southwest region. So people keep moving. So in order to sustain the vision, we have to do auditions as many times as possible to sustain the numbers.
How difficult was it for you to do this this venture?
It was really difficult because, you know, when your parents send you to school, they expect you to come back with a degree, have a job, and do something rewarding, maybe salary-wise and the rest. So
exactly.
It was not easy at the level of maybe my family and other onlookers. But I must say my family has been a great support after that.
Okay.
Yes, other difficulties involve the constant rate at which people move in the choir.
Okay.
So, but my family was supportive.
Maybe people with whom you were at the university choir then?
At the start of the choir, yes.
No, I mean your former choir.
Where I was.
So, yeah, so did that constitute any threat to your vision?
Not exactly, but I was resourceful to the choir. So having to step aside to do something personal, to carry personal vision, it would not be easy for them to contend with. So it was not actually a threat, kind of, but kind of their grand frère has disappeared.
And if grand frère is disappearing for something
beautiful,
then everyone will embrace it. Cool. I see a lot of women in this choir, and you are a nice, handsome young guy. How easy is that for you to manage?
It's obviously difficult, but it's a gospel choir, and I think my days in the university choir, we had a lot of talk of spirituality, molding and building us. It's a training ground, the University of Buea Choir.
Wow.
And so I think God himself had to train me in an effective place to come out and stand as a vision bearer.
That's
so we
beautiful.
Had a lot of training, yeah.
So let us talk about the objectives of the choir now.
As I said, in your, as you asked in the previous question, the need to revamp the sector of choral music in Cameroon was one of the motivations. But I think a main motivation of the vision was to uplift the souls of humankind with beautiful voices. We're going through a lot in the world. Mm-hmm. So what else can we offer to the world than our beautiful voices to heal souls and uplift them?
Yeah, but you also told me that you're kind of molding artists who can go solo anytime.
Exactly.
Yeah,
that's why at the auditions we take in soloists. And our desire is that as they grow in the choir, they can step out and become recording artists of their own. And we actually have, you heard in the interview with the music director, some of our directors who are out now are actually recording artists.
Wow, that's so beautiful.
We have Junior Praise. He's a gospel artist now. He was
Junior
with the choir.
Praise?
Junior Praise. We see Yaoundé.
Okay, that's so beautiful. Even though I'm yet to have Junior Praise on this show. Ladies and gentlemen, when we come back from this gospel musical break, we are going to find out again from Mr. Betrand Focho exactly what other activities they undertake as a choir.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
I looked over Jordan, and what did I see? Coming forth to carry me home.
Yes, so
coming up to
carry me home.
Sweet Lord,
sweet
chariot,
light, coming forth to carry him swing low. Why don't you
sing down, sweet chariot, stop it, let me ride.
To
sing down, sweet chariot, stop it, let me ride. Let me ride, let me ride.
Oh.
Come on, easy. I've got all my other side.
Why don't you
sing down, sweet chariot, stop it, let me ride. Sing down, sweet chariot, stop it, let me ride. Let me ride, let me ride.
Oh.
Come on, easy. I've got all my other side.
Don't try to stop and let me.
Let me ride. Sing down, sing chara, stop it. Let me ride. Let me ride, let me ride. Come on, easy. I've got no money. Other side.
Don't you sing down, chara, stop and let me ride.
Let me ride. Sing down, sing chara, stop it. Let me ride. Let me ride, let me ride. Come on, easy. I've got no money. Other side.
I've got home.
Gentlemen, I cannot say too much. And when I told you at the beginning of the show that I came here 3 months ago and I found this choir very amazing, and immediately I told them that they needed to be on Shine Africa because I knew that Africa, that Cameroon would want to listen to them and also to see them. Well, I'm so glad to see all of you again. I saw you like many months ago, and I'm so happy that you all are here. I was actually so ready to bring all of you to Yaoundé, but thank God we are here in Buea. So we're going to have you on another show because I've not had enough of what you people can offer. See you some other time. Thank you very much.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
You're welcome back from that very, very, very beautiful and exciting break, ladies and gentlemen. If you are just joining us, you're still on Shine Africa, and we are still in Buea, the regional capital of the Southwest. And of course, we are still at the Mountain Hotel. And I'm still in the company of the founder and CEO of the Cameroon Afro Gospel Choir, Mr. Focho Betrand. Now, I'd like to talk about your activities. What sort of activities do you undertake in the choir?
Okay, before I go to activities, one of our objectives is also to portray the cultural diversity of Cameroon through the Sahel, Fang Beti, grass field, and sour cultural extractions.
That's beautiful.
So our activities will involve participating in cultural events, animating at weddings, funerals, book launch, and what have you. So we have a lot of activities we undertake. We also have our concerts that we organize.
That's beautiful.
Yearly. So yearly we have the Christmas pageant. So we have done three of them. Pageant 1, pageant 2, and pageant 3. 2017 to 2019 respectively.
Every Christmas season.
Every Christmas season we are on.
Yeah, that's so beautiful. I also saw you with some CDs. Can you show them to us? Can the camera pick that, please? Jordan, is that your first, is an audio?
It's an audio.
An audio, yeah. Yes. Tell me about it.
It's the very first, the title Jordan, the song we did, Swing Low, I'm Crossing Over to Jordan. So we decided to title that Jordan to depict the fact that we are crossing over to the better side of things.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
That's so beautiful. So on a daily basis, what do you do? Do you have a meeting spot? Do you people have a place where you meet for rehearsals or something?
Yes, exactly. We meet just once a week on Sundays.
Okay.
On Sundays, yes. The choristers are required to learn their songs personally, and we come on Sunday for performances.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we meet every Sunday for rehearsal sessions.
We are in 2020, and the Anglophone crisis is still ongoing. I'm very surprised that you could bring together this number of choristers. Is it not affecting you?
Not at all. You know, it's said that where there is a will, there is a way.
Amen.
And when you are responding to God's call, He makes provision for whatever He's
called
you to do.
Yeah.
So our objective is to uplift the souls of humankind. So He knows that. And so He makes it possible every time.
Amen. Amen. What a beautiful show, ladies and gentlemen. I think that we still have a lot in store. But then I like to talk about difficulties. I've not heard. Everything you're talking about is so sugar-coated. But I know that dealing with people, this number of people, 35 plus, you must be facing some challenges. And if someone wanted to join this choir, what challenges would they be expecting?
Okay, first, from my part as a leader, it's said uneasy is the head that wears the crown.
Yeah.
You know, having to deal with people who are talented. Talented people are a difficult group of people to deal with. But as I said, God has given me the grace to be able to handle everything, and I give Him the praise.
Yeah.
And the part of the choir, we have a lot of challenges, you know, dreaming of a lofty vision like this in the context of us, like Cameroon, the country is really difficult.
Very difficult.
So we have
for entertainment.
Entertainment industry. We have a lot of difficulties. You know, our voices are wonderful. Mm-hmm. They are great. People compliment us. But we lack adequate sound to be able to bring this out to people. We also lack funds. We don't have sponsors that can be able to fund the choirs.
So are you looking for sponsors to support the choir?
Of course, we need sponsors.
Okay.
We also have as objective to share this beautiful music with the rest of the world. So if there are any people out there who can help us get this out of the world and make Cameroon proud, we're ready for you.
Wow, that's so beautiful. And like I always say on the show, Shine Africa, these are the sort of things that we Cameroonians, we Africans should be promoting. And just before we go on the next note, you are also a chorister, but you're not singing with the choir. So what happens to your own dream?
Personally, I don't have a dream as a musician per se. My dream is leadership, and it's a calling I have. So anywhere leadership, you find me.
That's very beautiful. And now, there are a lot of people that have been listening to Betrand talk, and I believe that they should have some questions for him. Please, what can your question be? The audience question.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
My name is Njongo Vanessa. With the vision you have said, do you have any fears or worries?
Of course, I'm a human being at the end of the day, so I should have a lot of fears. And top on the list of fears is the fact that the group can just become extinct in one day. Of course, you should all fear that.
Okay.
Not so. Don't you fear that your show can end too?
I'm telling you.
Yes. So I fear that the group could end one day. Also, though it can never end.
Yeah.
Also, one of my worries is, are we going to be able to get to the hallmark of our dreams?
Yeah.
Are we going to be able to get to the hallmark of it?
Well, that's beautiful. I think it's, especially because you're confident of yourself, I think you're going to make it. You don't need to fear.
Amen.
Okay, now you've been on the hot seat ever since you came. Now is the time for you to ask me a question. What would that be? Not a difficult one, please.
Okay, how did you come about being a presenter of Shine Africa?
Just like you, I had a dream. Yes, I am also the founder and the producer, executive producer of Shine Africa. So I had a dream, and it's not my first show. I did a Better Live on Afrique Nouvelle in Bamenda. I was one of the first journalists to work on Afrique Nouvelle. And so I did, that was my first talk show on radio and television. That was Afrique Nouvelle and ROTN, Republican Television Network. And so this is, I mean, this is the first major something I'm doing. And it's just a dream come true like yours. Did I answer that question?
Effectively.
Thank you. 5 on 5.
5 on 5.
Now it's my favorite slot on the show. It's the dance slot. What did you say we should dance to again?
Prosper Menko, Holy Ghost Party.
Holy Ghost
Party.
Holy Ghost Party.
Shine, Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
Wow. Wow. Somebody would think that you'll not be able to dance, but you're doing it so well. And so we're going to see how many marks you've made for yourself just dancing. Is it a 5?
No.
Is it a 7?
No.
Is it a 9?
Yeah.
Whoa. Some people are agitating. You got 9 on 10, just dancing here on Shine Africa. And you're not going to sit down anymore, please. Come and leave your founder, CEO, and choral signature on our African calabash. Just get any space and write your name on it, please. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much. You do not come on Shine Africa and go back empty-handed. So we are going to give you a gift that you probably keep in somewhere in a library or something, the Shine Africa pillow. This
thank
is
you very much.
Thank you. Thank you too, and thank you for coming. Thank you.
Shine Africa, shine. Shine, Africa, shine.
Before we take leave of you, ladies and gentlemen, here is our watchword. It is an African proverb on war and peace, and it says, removing a piece of yam from the pot of yam doesn't stop the rest from cooking. Removing a piece of yam from the pot of yam doesn't stop the rest from cooking. It's here we call it a wrap on this edition of the program, ladies and gentlemen. And we'd like to say a very big thank you to the management of Mountain Hotel here in Buea. And of course, to my amazing crew. And until next week, I remain your host, the Reverend Abongta Mirabel Suringwa. And it's a bye-bye from me to you. Bye-bye.